classes. I'm here, Jayashree, to teach you 7th standard mathematics. Right? So, mathematics is the most beautiful and most powerful creation of the human spirit. So, by saying this, I am going to start the first chapter, that is the integers. So, in this class, we are going to learn the objectives or introduction about the integers and exercise 1.1 question number 1 and question number 2. So we are going to solve the first question and second question, right? So what are the integers? See the introduction about the integers. So in the previous class we have learned that whole numbers, natural numbers and integers, right? So let's recall all those at once. Okay, so first one is natural numbers. So what are the natural numbers? So natural numbers are the counting numbers. So we start to count from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? So these are all the natural numbers. So these natural numbers set or denoted by the letter capital N. So capital N is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So countable numbers are infinite. So it is up to infinite. Means it has endless. Okay? The second one is whole numbers. So whole numbers including 0, all the natural numbers are whole numbers. Including 0, all the natural numbers are whole numbers. Right? So these whole numbers set is denoted by the letter capital W. Okay? So natural numbers, whole numbers, then also we have learned positive numbers and negative numbers. So what are the positive numbers? Positive numbers, the natural numbers having the sign plus. The natural numbers having the sign plus are all the positive numbers. Plus 1, plus 2 and plus. So these are all the positive numbers. Then what are the negative numbers? The numbers with the negative sign. So minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So these are all the negative numbers. Okay. So positive numbers and negative numbers. Then let's see your integers. So integer is a collection of a big integers or the big collection of numbers. It includes whole numbers, positive numbers and negative numbers. So let's see here. The integers are denoted by the letter capital Z, or we can also represent by the letter capital Z. Okay. So integer set Z is equals to 0, comma plus or minus 1. So plus or minus 1 means it is positive 1 and also negative 1. Okay. And a positive 2 and a negative 2 means positive number 2 and negative number 2. So this set is the set of integers, right? So it is about the integers. Okay, then let's see here. The previous class we have learned the representation of integers on a number line, right? So it is the number line. It is the number line. So you may see here there are the negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers. So on the number line, we represent the negative numbers to the left of the 0. So here there is a 0. We represent the negative numbers to the left of the 0. And we represent the positive numbers to the right of the 0. Okay. So here I want the minus 5. Minus 1 and plus 3. Okay. So can you arrange these numbers in an ascending order? Ascending order means that is the smallest to greatest. Right. So can you arrange these in the ascending order? Yes. Here we know that. So we know that the values goes on decreasing to the left of the 0. To the left of the number line. So for example, here this is a 3, right? So if we go to the left of the number line, we will get the lesser values. Okay, then if we go to the right of the number line, we will get the greater values. Okay, so for example, you may see here. So here there is a 3. So if we go left side, we will get the lesser numbers. Okay, then let's write the marked integers. So marked integers in a ascending order. Can you tell me which is the smallest integer? Minus 5, minus 1 or 3? So So I say that if we go to the left of the number line, we will get the lesser number. Lesser number means smaller number. So if we come to the left of the number line, we will get the lesser number. So here minus 5 is the lesser number. And if we go to the right of the number line, we will get the greater values. Okay, so here minus 1 and 3. So minus 1 is greater than minus 5. So why? Because minus 1 is right to the minus 5. Right? And the minus 1 is smaller than 3. Minus 1 is smaller than 3. Why? Because minus 1 is left to the 3. So left, if you go to the left side of the number line, left to the number line, you get the lesser values. If you go right to the number line, you will get the greater values. I hope it's clear. Okay, then let's see some of the statements here to add the and subtract the integers. So you may see, to add a positive integer, we move to the right. Okay, so move to right. And to add a negative integer, we move to the left. Move to left. Okay. To subtract a positive integer, we move to left. To subtract a negative integer, we move to right. Okay. So it is about the number line. Here there are the statements. So we have to check whether it is correct or incorrect. Okay. So then let's see here. The first statement is, when two positive integers are added, we get a positive integer. So let's see here. When two positive integers added, we get a positive integer. Is it correct or not? Let's see by the example. Okay, so the example is, I will take here 25 is a positive integer and plus, they said it to be add, plus 9 which is equals to. So 25 plus 9 which is equals to 34. So 25 is a positive integer and 9 is a positive integer. So we get the sum as a positive integer. So the given statement is correct, right? So when two positive integers are added, we get a positive integer. Okay, then let's see the second statement. When two negative integers are added, we get a positive integer. When two negative integers are added, we get a positive integer. Let's see whether it is a right or wrong. So let's take an example. Minus 9 plus of minus 3. So here minus 9 is a negative integer and minus 3 is a negative integer. So here I am going to add these two negative integers. So okay, so when here there is a plus symbol, so it will minus 9. So here there is a minus 3. So if you multiply, so plus into minus is minus 3. Okay, so here these two all negative integers are the same sign, so we have to add. So add here 9 plus 3 is 12. Okay, so here the greater number is 9, so it has a sign negative, so we have to keep the negative sign. So the sum of two negative integers is a negative integer. It is not a positive integer. So the given statement is wrong. So we can correct it. When two negative integers are added, we will get a negative integer, not a positive integer. Okay. Then the third statement is, when a positive integer and a negative integer are added, we always get a negative integer. So it's a wrong statement. So why? Because when a positive integer and negative integers are added, so we will not get a negative negative integer. So let's see here, 7 plus of minus 6. So 7 is a positive integer and 6 is a minus 6 is a negative integer. So if I add a positive integer and a negative integer, so what we get? Let's see here, 7 right as it is. So plus into minus is minus, then 6. So which is equal to 7 minus 6 is 1. So we have to keep the sign, right? So compare here 7 and 6. So in these two numbers, 7 is a greater number. It has a sign plus. So we have to keep the sign for the sum. So that is the positive. Okay. So according to the example, the given statement is wrong, right? So when a positive integer and a negative integer are added, we always get a negative integer. It's all depend upon the greater number and its sign. Okay. Then the fourth one statement is additive inverse of an integer 8 is minus 8, and the additive inverse of minus 8 is 8. Yes, the given statement is true. So the additive inverse of the 8 is minus 8, and the minus additive inverse of minus 8 is 8. For example, you may take additive inverse of 10 is equals to, that is additive inverse of 10 is equals to minus 10, and additive inverse of minus 8 is equals to 8. Okay, so you may take some more examples like this. So additive inverse of a given number. So if it is a positive number, additive inverse will be the negative number. If it is a negative number, additive inverse of the number is a positive number. So the given statement is true. So then let's see the fifth statement. Okay, the fifth statement is, for subtraction we add additive inverse of the integer that is being subtracted to the other integer. So in the for the subtraction problem, so we have to take the additive inverse of the subtraction. So we know that it is the 56 is the prime and 73 is the subtraction. So we have to take the additive inverse of the 73 minus 73, that is the plus 73. So okay, let's see here, 56. So for the subtraction, so we have to take the additive inverse of minus 3. So after taking the inverse, the negative sign will changes into a positive, means subtraction will changes into additive. Okay, so minus 73 additive inverse is plus 73. So it is plus 73. So what is the sum here? So sum is equal to 6 plus 3 is 9. Then 5 plus 7 is 12. 129. Okay, then let's see here the second one example. The minus 73 minus of minus 100. So here the subtraction is minus 100. So we have to take the additive inverse of minus 100. So please don't take the additive inverse of minus 79. If you take the additive inverse for minus 79, you will get the wrong difference. Okay, so we have to take the additive inverse for the subtraction. So here the subtraction is minus 100. So additive, after taking the additive inverse, the subtraction symbol changes into a additive symbol. Okay, so first write the minus 79, then additive inverse of minus 100 is plus 100, then plus 100, so which is equals to, so here there is a minus symbol, here there is a plus symbol, so these two are having the different signs. So if the two numbers having the different sign, so we have to subtract, right? So subtract here, so 100 minus 79 is, 100 minus 79 is 0 minus 9 is, so 100 minus 79 is 129. So 100 minus 79 is 21. So here we have to keep the sign, whether it is positive 21 or negative 21. Let's check here. Here 100 is the greater number having the sign plus symbol. So we have to keep the plus symbol. Okay, so like this we have to subtract the given number using the additive inverse. Okay, then the sixth statement is minus 10 plus 3 which is equals to plus minus plus 10 minus 3. So you may observe here, so additive inverse of minus 10 is plus 10, additive inverse of plus 3 is minus 3. So it is the wrong statement. Why? Because we have to take the additive inverse only in the subtraction column, and we have to take the additive inverse for only the subtrahend, not for the minor end. Okay, so the given statement is wrong. Then which is the correct statement? Yes, you may see here the minus 10 is given, so write it as is. So here there is a plus symbol, means we have to add 3 to the negative integer 10. Okay, so just write it as 3. 3 which is equals to 10 minus, sorry, minus 10 plus 3. You may observe here there are the two different integers. So different integers are there, so we have to subtract. So 10 minus 3 is 7, and you may observe here the greater number is 10 having the sign negative. So which is the greater number and what it has the sign, so we have to place the sign to the sum. Okay, then the next part statement is n plus of minus 7 minus of minus 4 which is equals to 8 plus 7 minus 4. So you may observe here there is an addition, right? So for this addition we don't need to take the additive inverse, but here they have taken the additive inverse. So the given statement is wrong. So we have to correct it. Okay, so let's correct here. Okay, so here there is a plus 8, so plus of minus 7, so plus of minus 7 is minus 7, so plus into minus is minus, minus 7, and here there is a subtraction, so subtraction after it is a subtrahend, so we have to take the additive inverse. So after taking the additive inverse, the subtraction symbol will change into a addition. Okay, so now you will do the sum. So you may see here there is a plus 8 minus 7 plus 4. So first you may add the positive integers. Okay, 8 plus 4, here plus 8 plus 4, it is plus 12, then minus 7, then which is equals to, you may observe here there are the two different signs. Okay, so we have to subtract. So 12 minus 7 is 5. You may observe here 1 is the greater number and it has a sign positive. Okay, so the given, so the we take the sum, that is the positive integer, that is positive 5 or plus 5. Okay, so it is all of the given statements, whether it is correct or wrong, so we have completed. So I hope it's clear all about that. Then let's go to solve the exercise 1.1 first question. Yes. Dear students, let's start the exercise 1.1. The first question is, following number line shows the temperature in degrees Celsius at different places on a particular day. So here they are given the number line. So it is the first city. So I have written the short form, that is the Lahul Spiti and Srinagar, Shimla, Ubi and Bangalore. Okay, so we have to write Bangalore. Okay, then let's see the first question. So observe this number line and write the temperature of the places marked. Okay, so by observing this number line, so we have to write the temperature of the given cities. So you may observe here, so here there is a 0, so 0 to left side of the 0 or the negative integers, right? So here 0, so each point will represent minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Here after the 0 it has a 2 points, that means it is the minus 2 degree Celsius. Okay, and the Lahul Spiti, so after the minus 5 it has a 3 digits, minus 5 here, minus 6, minus 7 and minus 8 degree Celsius. The temperature of the Lahul Spiti is minus 8 degree Celsius, and the temperature of the Shimla is exactly the 5 degree Celsius. It is right into the zero, so it is a positive integer. Okay, and the OT. So OT is left to the 1 point, left to the 15. So it is 14 degree Celsius. And the Bangalore. So Bangalore is after the 20. It has two places. That means 22 degree Celsius. Okay, so let's note here the first question. Observe the number line and write the temperature of the places marked on it. Okay, so here I have taken the termination column for to write the name of the cities and the temperature. So let's write here what is the temperature of the Lahul Spiti, that is -8 degree Celsius, and the second one is Srinagar. Srinagar, it has a -2 degree Celsius, and the temperature of the Shimla is 5 degree Celsius. So it is the positive integer, and the temperature of the Ooty is +14 degree Celsius, and the temperature of the Bangalore is 22 degree Celsius. Okay, yes. Then let's see the second question. Yes. What is the temperature difference between the hottest and the coldest places among the above? So you may observe here. So in the before I have said that if you go to the left of the number line, you will get the least value, and go to the right to the number value, number line, you will get the greater values. Okay. So which city having the coldest temperature? So coldest means it is the negative temperature, that is the Lahul Spiti, and which is the hottest? Hottest means which is the greater integer, so that is the 22 degree Celsius. So Lahul Spiti is the coldest city and Bangalore is the hottest city. So here they are asking what is the temperature difference. So difference means we have to subtract these two, right? So okay, let's write here the temperature. So you may write here, it is the coldest, it is the hottest. Okay, so let's write the B question answer. The temperature difference between the temperature difference between coldest and hottest places. In the right view, here the greater value is hottest, hottest and coldest place is equal to, right here the hottest place is +22. Here they are asking the difference, that means we have to subtract minus the coldest place is now between has a -8 degree. Okay, so let me see here we have to subtract. Right? So in the previous statement we have seen that for subtraction we have to take the additive in this inverse for the subtrahend. Right? So as you may write here +22. So after taking the additive inverse, the subtraction symbol will change into a addition symbol. Additive inverse of -8 is +8. So which is equals to, you may see here the two numbers having the same sign, that is plus. Okay, so add here 22 plus 8 is 30, and here the greater number is 22 having the sign positive. So write it at last in the sum. It is the temperature difference between the hottest and the coldest place is +33 degree Celsius. Okay, it's clear? Yes. Then let's go to the C question. Same question is, what is the temperature difference between Lahul Spiti and Srinagar? So here we have to find out the temperature difference between Lahul Spiti and Srinagar. Okay, then write down here C1, the temperature difference between the difference between Lahul Spiti and Srinagar.
And also they said to
And also they asked, is it also less than the temperature at Srinagar? So here the Srinagar is -2 degrees Celsius. No, it is not less than the temperature at Srinagar. Okay, then why don't you know? The temperature of Srinagar and Shimla taken together is not less than Shimla. Is not less than the temperature of Srinagar. Is not less than the temperature of Srinagar. It's clear? Yes, sir. Up to here we have solved the first question, then let's go to solve the second question. The second question is, in a quiz, positive marks are given for correct answers and the negative marks are given for incorrect answers. So if Jack scores in 5 successive rounds were 25, minus 5, minus 10, 15 and 10. So what was his total at the end? So here Jack is one of the 4. In a quiz, he scored in 5 successive rounds. So that is work here. So 25, minus 5, minus 10, 15 and 10. Okay. So what is his total score? So first what we have to write here, total they asked here. So we have to add all the scores. Okay. So first write here, Jack scored in 5 successive rounds. Jack's score in 5 successive rounds. Then write here 25, minus 5, minus 10, 15 and 10. Right? Yes. Then what is the total? The total score of Jack at the end. Write down here. The total score. Total score of Jack at the end. At the end. Yes. Total score they asked. So we have to add all the scores. Then first item here, 25 is a positive integer, plus of minus 5, then plus of minus 10, plus of 15, then plus 10. Okay, so see here, write down the 25 here, the subtraction, so plus into minus is minus, minus 5. And plus into minus, minus is 10, plus 15, plus 10. Okay? Now, so first add the positive integers, 25, 15 and 10. So 25 plus 15, that is 40, 40 plus 10 is 50. 50, then add the negative integers, so minus 5 and minus 10. So minus 5 minus 10, that is minus 50. Okay, then here plus 50 and minus 50 are different signs, so we have to subtract here. So we will get the, so 50 minus 50 is 35. Here the greater number is 50 having the positive sign. So therefore the total score of the Jack at the end is 35 marks. Okay, so then write down here, therefore total score, Jack's total score at the end is 35. Okay, it's clear? Yes. So up to here, in this class we have learned the introduction about the integers, and also we have solved the first two questions in the exercise 1.1, and the rest of the questions we are going to solve in the next class. Okay, thank you.